So, you have your 3D character rigged and skinned, even animated maybe. But you found out that it has a wrong scale. It's too small or too large. So what do you do? How do you scale it now? No, not like this.
Not like this.
Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Čep. Okay, so how to scale a cat rig? For those who are here just to quickly see how it's done, I will show it first, and later after that explain what I'm doing for those who want to learn what I'm clicking and why. First, make sure you turn off the animation mode, if it's not already. That's extremely important. Select your mesh and disable the skin modifier. Head down to Advanced Parameters Rollout and disable Always Deform. That's also very important. If you have multiple meshes in your rig, just do the same thing for all of them as well. Select the cat parent triangle and write down the current cat units ratio. Now adjust the cat units ratio to the size you need. Now do some crazy advanced scientific math. Figure out what's the percentage change between these two numbers. Take this second number you have, multiply it by 100 and divide it by the first number you had before. Okay, so 205. Select the mesh and scale it to that number. Go to Utilities panel and hit Reset X-Form. Move it under the skin modifier and collapse it into the editable poly. Re-enable the skin modifier with Always Deform and job's done. Character scaled. Everything's working as expected. But let's do this process once more with a bit more explaining. So for those 5 of you still watching, turn off the animation mode. Always make sure this is the case, anytime you are doing changes to the rig in CAD. I mean every time. I have to admit, it happens to all of us that you do changes for 30 minutes only to realize you did them in the animation mode instead of the setup mode.
No!
Next, we have to disable the skin modifier for our mesh, or multiple meshes. If we didn't do that and try to rescale the model just by changing the CAD units ratio, this would happen. The mesh would deform. So we have to scale the rig and mesh separately. Disable the skin modifier then. But now, as I have shown before, you also have to disable the always deform parameter. I will show you why. Skin modifier currently has all the weight values saved for each vertex of the mesh, values you have set by skinning the model. And these values of vertices are in a relationship with the position of the bones. So now, when the skin modifier is disabled, you could change the rig and move the bone or scale the rig. However, when you then re-enable the skin modifier back, you can see that it didn't work because the relationship between the vertices and the bones didn't change. If you now disable and enable it, you can see that a change happened. Because we have basically reset the relationship between them and told the skin modifier that this is the new and correct relationship. Okay, let's undo all this and continue. So now that the mesh is basically detached from the rig, we can scale the rig however we like. We then need to scale the mesh by the exact same amount, so everything is at the same place as it was before. That's why we have calculated the percentage. Again, it's very simple. Take the new CAD units ratio number, multiply it by 100, and divide it by the old number. Now when everything is matched properly, we have to reset the transformation values for the mesh, so everything is zeroed out. You always want the scale to be 100%, not any other number. It can mess up with some features in game engines or even with some scripts here in Max. And even though I think it's not that important nowadays and that most stuff can deal with not having scale at 100%, you still want to keep it clean. Which is why we use Reset X-Form. This modifier serves the purpose of telling the transformations that this is the original position, rotation and scale. You can see that the scale is back to 100% again, and we can collapse the modifier into the editable poly, to keep the modifier stack clean. Now we can just re-enable the skin modifier, together with Always Deform, and the rescaling is done. If you had some animations animated already on this character, they might be messed up after the rescaling. Not the case here, but they might be. You can solve that by saving them to clips and loading them back on the rescale rig. Basically, you have to open your old file where the animation is animated in the original scale. Save the animation stack into the clip and open up this max file where you have done the rescaling and load the clip here. All the animations should load fine and work without a problem. And that's all. After the last video that was a bit more complicated, this one should be quite easy to understand even for beginners, but still very important to know. Hope you have enjoyed it and see you in another video. I'm Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.